blessed and praised every moment be the most holy divine sacrament. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Blessed and praised every moment be the most holy divine sacrament. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Blessed and praised every moment be the most holy divine sacrament. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Come away by yourself and rest a while with me, says the Lord. And so we spend a few moments of silent intimacy with the Lord, bringing to Him our aspirations and anxieties, our success and failure. Of all that is good and that which is not so good in us. The Eucharist is real presence. Christ is present to us in the form of bread and wine during the Eucharist. Soul and divinity. And as we experience Him in the form of bread and wine, we go out and discover Him and experience Him in everything and in everyone and in all situations of life. And so let's ask the Lord to open our hearts and minds as we pray. Lord, help us to experience your presence.
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In your marvelous creation,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In the sun that rises every morning,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In the setting sun of every day,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In every temptation and in pain,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In success and in failure,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In every person who is close to us,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In those who guide us in our life,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In political and social options,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In the family in which we were born,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In the community in which we serve,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In those who love us,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In those who are indifferent to us,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In those who have done us evil,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In every poor or sick person,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In every elderly person,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In every person who is incarcerated,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In every person in need of conversion,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
In every sister and brother,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
And in all events of life,
Lord, help us to experience your presence.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit exalts in God my Savior, for he has looked with mercy on my lowliness. And my name will be forever exalted. For the mighty God has done great things for me, and his mercy will reach from age to age. Has mercy in every generation. He has revealed his power and his glory. He has cast down the mighty. Has lifted up the meek and the lowly. He has come to help his servant Israel. He remembers his promise to our father. Holy, holy, holy.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what sort of greeting this might be, and pondered what this greeting was about. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of David his father, and of his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with the man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived in her womb, and this is the sixth month for her who was called barren. For nothing is impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done unto me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Sisters and brothers, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
This evening, as we gather before the Eucharistic Lord, we become aware that we are in the month of October, and we just celebrated the feast of Our Lady of the Holy Rosary. And so we would like to gaze upon him through the eyes of our Blessed Mother. In fact, each time we say the Angelus, each time we say the Hail Mary, or for that matter, whenever we recite the Holy Rosary, all we are doing is feeling with her, seeing through her eyes the face of Jesus. Although the Holy Rosary is a Marian prayer, it is in fact, at its core, a Christocentric prayer. It is a scriptural prayer. Although we use words, it actually leads us into a contemplation, a prayer that could set a kind of a rhythm for you to go about with the other works during the day. A prayer that brings you closer to Jesus through Mary. After all, as we recite the Rosary, do we not contemplate and delve deeper into the infancy of Jesus, or eventually into his passion and death? And as we recite the glorious mysteries, we dive deeper into his resurrection. And Pope John Paul II would later on go on to introduce what he called the mysteries of light, and we call them luminous mysteries. It's all a reflection and contemplation on the kingdom of God. And so as we recite the prayer, the Holy Rosary, what we do is doing what she did. And we read in the scriptures, and she pondered what sort of greeting this was. And Luke would go on to say in chapter 2, verse 19, and also in verse 21, and Mary kept all these things in her heart and pondered over them. Sisters and brothers, the Rosary is a prayer that invites us to get closer to the Lord and to his mysteries. It is a prayer that sets the conditions right and creates a kind of an atmosphere for us to draw closer to him. It is as though we want to immerse ourselves in the mysteries of the Lord and allow ourselves to be, if I may say so, be pickled and marinated in the mysteries of Jesus. Unless and until we allow ourselves to sit with it, it's not going to sit in our hearts. And so let's pray. Let's pause. Let's dive deeper into the mysteries of the Lord through the recitation of the Holy Rosary, and we will walk the way that our Blessed Mother walked, the way of Jesus. For when you go to the Mother, all she tells you is, do whatever he tells you. And so, praying the Rosary, reflecting and contemplating on the mysteries of Christ, let us resolve to do what he wants us to do.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, star, so strong and bright. gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by the Father, you were chosen for the Son.
Let your response be, Lord, may we listen to your word in all situations of life.
Lord,
may we listen to your word in all situations of life. Lord, I listen to your word even when it upsets me in moments of difficult choices, as in the case of the Virgin of Nazareth.
Lord, may we listen to your word in all situations of life.
Lord, I listen to your word even when it asks me to leave my father and mother, my family and work, as in the case of Peter and Andrew and the sons of Zebedee.
Lord, may we listen to your word in all situations of life.
Lord, I listen to your word even when it demands from me a change of life and mentality, as in the case of Matthew.
Lord, may we listen to your word in all situations of life.
Lord, I listen to your word even when it asks of me to be reborn, as in the case of Nicodemus.
Lord, may we listen to your word in all situations of life.
Lord, I listen to your word even when it requires of me the acceptance of the gravity of my sins, as in the case of the Samaritan woman.
Lord, may we listen to your word in all situations of life.
Lord, I listen to your word even when it disturbs my own security, as in the case of the Pharisees.
Lord, may we listen to your word in all situations of life.
Lord, I listen to your word even when you ask me to continue hoping in the face of death of someone dear to me, as in the case of Mary and Martha.
Lord, may we listen to your word in all situations of life.
Lord, I listen to your word even when you invite me to follow you on the way of the cross.
Lord, may we listen to your word in all situations of life.
Let's pause for a while in silent adoration. Praying for the grace that we may listen to his word in all events and situations of life.
Tantum ergo sacramentum veneremur cernui et antiquum documentum novo cedat ritui prestet fides supplementum sensum defectui. Genitori genitoque laus eubilatio salus honor virtus quoque sit et benedictio procedenti ab utroque comparsit laudatio. Amen.
You gave them bread from heaven, containing in itself all sweetness. Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you gave us the Eucharist as a memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of the sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you won for us, and the peace of your kingdom, where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Blessed be God.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus Christ in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be Jesus Christ in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be her glorious assumption.
Blessed be her glorious assumption.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.